Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So before, pinag-aralan natin yung mode 2 ng calculator. Ngayon naman ay pag-aaralan natin yung mode 3 ng calculator. So first, nireset ko muna yung calculator ko kasi before naka-mode 2 siya. So paano nga ba mag-set sa mode 3? Press mo lang to na mode, press 3, which is statistics. Helpful siya sa statistics and more on statistic naman yung mode 3. So, ang meaning na to ng 1 tapos dash var, meaning yan is single variable. Meaning naman ng a plus bx is linear regression. And then, eto na may cx squared dito. Ang pangalan naman nito is quadratic regression, and then tong ln of x is logarithmic regression, and e raised to x is exponential regression, and a multiplied by b raised to x is ab exponential regression, and this one is a multiplied by x raised to b is the power regression, and 1 over x is the inverse regression. So, ang pipindutin muna natin is single variable. Okay? So, pwede mo na siya dyan ma-plug kung anong gusto mong data or kung anong given data na binigay sa'yo sa problem. Kasi, with this, easier na siya. Okay? So, let's have our first example. Ang example number 1 natin is find the mean of Nana's grade 90, 91, 85, 75, and 80. So, i-plug in na natin siya as our x value. Lagay mo 90, 91, and then 85, and then 75. Okay? So, that's it. Then, may 80 value pa pala. So, ayan na yung mga data na nilagay nyo na sa calculator. Press AC. Press Shift. Press 1. Tapos, baba. I mean, press 4. And then, eto. Meaning neto, number of data. Meaning nito, standard deviation. Tapos, ito yung mean, number 2. Pipindutin natin yung number 2. So, press equal sign. So, ang magiging mean ng data natin is 84.2. Simple as that, may sagot na tayo. Okay? So, let's head on to example number 2. Ang example number 2, given the statistical data, find the standard deviation 14, 20, 22, 1, and 15. So, yun na nga. Yun na yung data natin. So, press on. Tanggalin ko muna yung mga data. Shift clear 3 equals AC. Okay? So, press mode. Press 3, press 1, and then ano yung data, which is 14, equals 20, equals 21, equals 1, equals, and then 15. So, that's it. That's our data. Press AC, press Shift. Press 1, and then press 4, and then standard deviation yung hinahanap, so press 3. Ito yan, press 3, so press equal. So, that is our standard deviation, or approximately 7.14. Okay, as easy as that, may sagot ka na. So, paano mo mahanap yung sample variance? Ang sample variance is... Ang sample variance, pag kukuha ka ng sample variance, i-square root mo lang yung standard deviation. Makukuha mo na siya. How about this example number 3? May data na given, may frequency, and then may class mark. hanapin natin yung number of data, mean, standard deviation, and then variance. First, yun natin calculator natin. Tapos, i-delete ko lang shift. So, hello guys. Paano natin masisolve yung problem natin kanina? Easy. Mode. Press mode. Press 3. Statistics. 3. Press 1, which is single variable. So, X lang yung nakalagay dito na table. Kasi yung table natin composed of 2, frequency and then our X value. So, paano natin mat-turn on and off yung frequency? Press AC muna, shift, mode, and then press this button, yung downward. And then, press 4, statistics, and frequency on. So, check natin. Mode, 3, 1. So, dalawa na yung ating data. Paano naman mag-off? So, same as before, shift, mode, down, and then press 4, and then press 2. So, check na natin. Wala na yan. So, 3, 1. Oh, so, isa na lang. Pero, as the, sa ngayon, kailangan natin ng 2 tables. So, let's switch the frequency on. So, AC, shift, mode, down, and then press 4, and then press on. So, let's start by putting our known datas already. So, press 1, and that's it. So, let's press our data, which is 22, 31, 45, and then 63. Sa frequency naman, let's start. So, 1, 3, 2, 5, and then 6. So, that is our frequency. Okay? So, pag may data na tayo na nakalagay, press AC. And then shift. And then press 1, stat. And then press 4, variation. N means number of data. Press 1. So, press equals. So, ang mean natin is 16. I mean, ang number of data natin is 16. Tapos, AC. Press AC, shift. 1. And then 4. And then press 2, which is the mean. Hinahanap natin, mean. Press 2 and press equal sign. So, our mean is 45.6875 or 45.69 approximately. Tapos, press AC naman. Paghanap ng standard deviation, shift 1, 4, and then 3. Standard deviation. Equal sign. So, our standard deviation is 15.64. Paano mahanap yung variance? I-square mo lang itong answer mo. Pindutin mo lang to. Na square. And then, equal sign. Makukuha mo na yung variance, which is 244.71. Okay? So, that's it. Yan yung kung paano makuha yung ganitong type of problem. Makukuha mo agad yung sagot through calculator. Hindi mo na kailangan mag-solve pa. Bukod sa mga mean, median, etc., etc., pwede din natin ma-solve through the mode 3 ang areas in a normal curve by pressing mode, press 3, stat, and then press stats. Okay. Press AC na. So, naka-statistic mode na tayo. So, ang next mong gagawin is press AC and press shift and then press 1. Tapos, press 5. Ang option 5, meaning yan is normal distribution. So, press 5. And then, may P, Q, R, and itong T. Ang meaning ng PP is area from Z is equals to negative infinity to Z is equals to A. Pag halimbawa, ito naman na number 3, which is yung R, it means area from Z is equals to A to Z is equals to positive infinity. And then pag Q naman, it means the main area from Z is equals to 0 to Z is equals to A. So, let's do example number 1. Basta as long as naka-statistic mode tayo, okay lang yun. So, example natin number 1 is, find the area to the left of Z is equals to negative 1.54 from the standard normal curve. So, since area to the left, it means Z is equals to negative infinity to Z is equals to A. So, yung gagamitin natin is yung P. So, press AC, shift, and then 1, and then press 5, and then press 1, yung P. Tapos, ilalagay mo na dun yung given, which is negative 1.54. And then, press equal sign. So, this is our answer. Okay? So, press AC. Number 2. Example number 2. Find the area under the normal curve to the left of Z is equals to 1.3. So, mapapansin natin na ang given natin ay area from Z is equals to A to J is equals to positive infinity. So, yung gagamitin natin is yung R. So, we have to press AC, shift, 1, and then 5, and then 3. So, let's plug in our given, which is 1.3. Press equal sign. So, this is our answer, or approximately 0.1. Okay, and then for example number 3, find the area under the normal curve to the right of Z is equals to 1.2. So, basically, ang magagamit natin dito, area from Z is equals to 0 to Z is equals to 9, which is our Q. Press AC, shift, and then press 1, press 5, and then press 2. And then plug in our value, which is 1.2. Press 1.2. And equals, so that is our answer. Okay? So, that is it. Ito yung kung paano magsagot ng areas in the normal curve using calculator. That's it. I hope you learned something. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe to this channel for more videos.